إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek the help only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him, and whomever misguide, no one will guide him. I be witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. We still in the series of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and we spoke about the Sahabi Aliyun karramallahu wajhah wa radiallahu anhu, that great Sahabi, the Sahabi, the companion of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the cousin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first person become Muslim among of the youth. Aliyun radiyallahu anh, the one he never made sujood to any idols. He never did sujood other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aliyun radiyallahu anh, great Sahabi. And today, inshallah, we continue his story and his life during his Khilafah until he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ali radiallahu anhu and Fitnatul Khawarij. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know, all the believers, wherever they are and whomever they are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test the believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test each single mu'min or Muslim or any person. Qala ta'ala, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, Alif Lam Mim, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. سورة العنكبوت آية نمبر 2 قال ألف لام ميم أحسب الناس, is the people thinking, أحسب الناس, they have a thought, they will say آمنا, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وهم لا يفتنون, and they will not go through the test, they will not be tested by Allah. The answer giving, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surely will test every single person. وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested the people before in order Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowing, Allah know who is the truthful and who is liar. الصادقين والكاذبين. And in other verses in same surah, وَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. Allah will know the المؤمنين والمنافقين. So that's why the test will be go upon of each person. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test the Sahaba in so many different tests. And subhanallah, the always Sahaba winning in the test that Allah put them through. And also Ali radiallahu anhu, Allah test him the same. Allah test Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. Uthman ibn Affan, subhanallah, those hypocrites and bad people, they came all the way and they would want to put him down from his khilafah and he refused. And subhanallah, until they came and they killed Uthman radiyallahu anhu. Let's say, see the what happened to Ali radiyallahu anhu. Ali radiyallahu anhu, he go through fitnatul khawarij. Al khawarij is the group of the one of the group or one of the sect. Let's, before we go through the subhanallah story of Ali radiallahu anhu, I would like to tell you some information about Al-Khawarij. This is a group, sect, deviate from the Muslims. Al-Khawarij, the beginning of Al-Khawarij, after the battle of Siffin, which occurred between Ali radiallahu anhu and Muawiyah. Ali radiallahu anhu, Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan, both of them the Sahaba, great Sahaba, they had some khilaf, and they have some misunderstanding, shortcoming between them, an error, subhanallah. And after that, what happened? They fought each other with the call the Battle of Siffin. After that, the group of Khawarij raised up and they established. Subhanallah. How it happened? Ali radiallahu anhu and Muawiyah, subhanallah, they call up Hakam, mean judge. They select a group of people to be a judge, subhanallah, for them. And everybody accept their hukum, their judge. So after that, those group, they dislike that. How come Ali radiallahu anhu and Muawiyah, they went to choose a person to be a judge? Not, we should go to the Quran straight away. That's what they believe. So they come up with the idea that Ali radiallahu anhu and Muawiyah, they did not put the law of Allah upon them, so they are not Muslim. That's how they, wal'adhu billah, functioning their mind functioning in wrong way. Wal'adhu billah, mutashaddideen, they are very extreme. Then they establish, and subhanallah, some of them they repent to Allah, and some of them, wal'adhu billah, remain in the error. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari and Amr ibn al-As, those are the two Sahaba, they asked them to be a judge. And they said, we should delay the judge until Ramadan. Then subhanallah, faraja Ali biman ma'ahu min Siffin ila al-Kufa. Then the people with Ali radiallahu anhu, they went back to al-Kufa to stop the fight, subhanallah, until the waiting for the judge. But the Khawarij, they says, no, we shouldn't go back, and we are out of Ali radiallahu anhu, and we are out of the other group, and they claim, both of them, they are out of Islam. This is how the Khawarij start. They were 12,000 people, not small number. Ali radiallahu anhu, he was very wise. He chose to send to them Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he's a cousin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to talk to them. Then Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he went there and he spoke to them, and subhanallah, he tried to clarify some issues, the one they says. The issue, what they says, okay? First of all, when Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu tried to talk to them, what he said, first of all, they told him, Ali radiallahu anhu, they did not come back to choose the Quran as a hukum, as a law, as a principles. This is one of the issue. Then what Ibn Abbas he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in something very small, يحكم به ذوى عدل منكم هديا بالغ الكعبة, in hunting, subhanallah, if they in the surah, قال الله يحكم به ذوى عدل, who give the hukum for this, a person who is justice. In something very small things, Allah telling us as a law, we are allowed to use wise and justice a person to do the hukum. So how about if big issues? So we are not doing haram by choosing among of us muslihin, wise people among of the sahaba to solve the issue, solve the problem. So this is not out of a Quran and Sunnah. So Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu declared that shubha. Shubha mean error or doubt, doubtful. But still, They says no. They did not put the law of Allah, hukum. They are out of Islam. Still claiming Ali radiallahu anhu, and the rest is the subhanallah, they are out of Islam. So much extreme. And no one from them, from this 12,000 among them sahabi. All of them, they are not sahaba radiallahu anhu. Some of the ideas of the khawarij. First of all, for them it's easy, they go over the leader of the Muslim or Khalifa, whatever. If the Khalifa they dislike, they will go against him. They will not accept him as a Khalifa, even if small issues. So they went extreme. And sometimes if a person do like this, the country, what will happen to country? Country, if every Khalifa or every leader or every president or all the Muslim, if he make one error or one mistake, people should be against him. So there will never be a Khalifa exist, because every person he do mistake. So this idea is wrong. Second of the idea they used to believe, any person do major sin, he will be out of Islam. كفروا بالكبيرة. Any person do major sin or did major sin, he's out of Islam. And this is against of our aqidah. We not allow to call any Muslim, non-Muslim, whatever sin he commit, except shirk. If he والعياذ بالله fall in adultery or stealing, whatever, he's still Muslim, but he is sinner. For them, if anybody did steal or fall in fornication or العياذ بالله زنا or anything, they are out of Islam, خلاص, totally, in their aqidah. They are so extreme. Also, they تبرأوا من الخليفتين الراشدين عثمان وعلي رضي الله عنه. They says we are out from Ali radiallahu anhu and Uthman. They are not part of Muslims. They reject them. Also, some of the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they dropped. For example, if a person married وَالْعَذُ بِاللَّهِ fall in zina, in law of Islam, should be stoning until the death. And the Khawarij said this law is not exist, because they believe that person is out of Islam. Okay, no need to do the punishment over him. And another one, the law of Al-Qadhf. If a person claim that woman she did, وَالْعَذُ بِاللَّهِ zina, in Islam, if he didn't bring four witness, the punishment will be occur upon him. 80 slashed. That's we call haddu al-qadhf. Okay, for example, I said this lady, she commit zina. Where's the evidence? I don't have. The Khalifa, the law of Allah, I will be tortured, because I claim something, a big word without evidence. Okay, subhanallah, will be hit 80 slashed. For them, this law no more exists. Some of them, they deny Surah Yusuf. Surah Yusuf is not part of the Quran. وَالْعَذُ بِاللَّهِ. They will say the woman, she has menses or period, she has to back up the salah after that. So that's their, some of their faith. The Khawarij group. Why we learn? Because I tell you this to, in order to see how those people, when they come out from Quran and Sunnah, how they will be establishing so stupid ideas. That's why Rasulullah SAW always recommend us hold and stick to the word of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah SAW. And look these ideas, what they lead them. They lead them to kill Ali radiallahu anhu. They killed him. Ali radiallahu anhu, the cousin of Rasulullah SAW from Ahlul Bayt, one of the best of the Sahaba. That is the extremism. Okay. Some of the sifat of Al-Khawarij, some of their attribute, what Rasulullah described to us. Hadith عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في وصفهم الله, Rasulullah described them, يحق يحقر أحدكم صلاته مع صلاتهم وصيامه مع صيامهم، يقرؤون القرآن لا يجاوز تراقيهم، يمرقون من الدين كما يمرق السهم من الرمية. متفق عليه. حديث قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يحقر أحدكم صلاته إلى صلاة، يعني you analyze your salah compared to their salah is very little, nothing compared to their salah. They pray so much salat. Those khawarij, they pray so much. Compared to your salah is nothing. Maybe they pray all the night. وَصِيَامَهُ مَعْ صِيَامِهِمْ. You see them, they fast all the times. Subhanallah. How come those, they doing salah for so much salat and so much fasting, but still, قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقرؤون القرآن لا يجاوز تراقيم. They recite Quran, the Quran will not go over their recitation only. They only recite Quran, but meaning of the Quran, understand the Quran right way, they are zero. They twist the word of Allah in the wrong way. And this is really warning. Subhanallah. يمرقون من الدين. They pass by the deen, the religion of Allah, the Islam, as the كما يمرق السهم من الرمية. يعني the, see how the arrow will pass by the what do you call, where you try to throw the arrow. They pass by. And this how they use, they see the religion, the Islam, the deen of Allah, but they pass by, they will not follow the right way. Subhanallah. Ar-Rasul Sam described them. Another they say zuhud wa ibadah wa khubthu i'tiqad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are very zahid, very good. Okay? And they are very good in worship, but they have evil faith. Can you imagine? A person, he's very wearing rough clothes, showing he doesn't like the dunya, he doesn't like to follow dunya out of desire, and subhanallah, and he worships so much humble, but we look at the faith, so much evil. Wal'a'adhu billah. So this is not as Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. Subhanallah. And what the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم described in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, he said يقتلون أهل الإسلام ويدعون أهل الأوثان. They kill the people of the Muslim people and they leave non-Muslim people. يعني for them killing the Muslim, we are closer to Allah by killing the Muslim, but they will never fight non-Muslim. والعياذ بالله. And look at now, We don't have khawarij now, alhamdulillah. So far in my knowledge, they are not exist anymore, they already gone. But what can some of their wrongs we can apply in our time? Look at in Muslim land, they kill the Muslim, kill the other Muslim. Subhanallah. Look in Syria, the government killing their own Muslims, and they will never shoot one bullet to Israel. And the Israel took one land part of Syria, they call Al-Julan, big land. Al-Julan is a part of Syria. They took it to Israel. They never even shoot a bullet to them, but they killed their own people. Subhanallah. So this is what Adhu Billah is really evil, evil act. And also Ali radiallahu anhu, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described that people, those people, they are hudatha'ul asnan wa sufaha'ul ahlam. Mean they are very young and they have a small thinking and weakness in their thinking. They had weakness in their thinking. Subhanallah. So Amir al-Mu'mineen, subhanallah, Ali radiallahu an, he did amazing things against them. Look, even all this bad ideas they have, Ali radiallahu anhu, he said to them, أَلَا إِنَّ لَكُمْ عِنْدِي ثَلَاثَ خِلَالٍ مَا كُنْتُمْ مَعَنَا لَنْ نَمْنَعَكُمْ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ. As long you are with us, I will not stop you three things. لَنْ نَمْنَعَكُمْ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ. We will not stop you going to masajid, to mosque. And we will not stop giving you sadaqah if among you are poor people. And we will not fight you at all until you fight us. SubhanAllah, teaching us Islam, how is the right, what we do with the people who is against us. We don't, Ali Radha, he didn't raise the sword and he said, yes, you have this faith, cut their head. No. What he did, Ali Radha, he told them, as long you are with us, we allow you to pray with us. We give you the poor among you, we help, and we will never fight you unless if you fight us. SubhanAllah. This is just summarizing about the Al-Khawarij. Let's come back to the story of Ali radiallahu anh and his fitna with them. Before I go through, what the mu'min or what is a believer should do in the time of fitna is really important. And really this one I wish you write and memorize what we're going to say. Because you analyze our time. Fitna after fitna, fitna after fitna, fitna behind fitna. SubhanAllah, we wake up full of fitna around us. La ilaha illallah. So what we should do? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned about an fitan sataqa' ba'dahu. Rasul mentioned there's a fitna, fitan, plural word. Many fitna will come as al-layl al-muzlim. كَقِطَعِ اللَّيْلِ الْمُظْلِمِ as the piece of the part of the dark night. Okay? Part of the dark night. SubhanAllah. تَمُوجُ بِالنَّاسِ كَمَا يَمُوجُ الْبَحْرِ. That fitna will carry the people as the wave carry, SubhanAllah, the things. People wake up in the morning, Muslim. Come in the night, kafir. In the night become Muslim, in the morning become kafir. He sell his deen for little material things. Allah al-musta'an. Astaghfirullah. May Allah save us from fitna. What is the hadith? Hadith fi al-mustadrak ala al-sahihain wa rawahu al-imam al-tirmidhi wa musannaf ibn Abi Shayba. Okay? Qalu hadithun sahih. Qala yakunu bayna yaday sa'a fitanun ka qita'i al-layl al-muzlim. Yusbihu al-rajlu fiha mu'minan. ويمسي كافرا ويمسي مؤمنا ويصبح كافرا يبيع أقوام دينه بعرض من الدنيا. حديث تكون mean will be between the day of judgment, يعني سبحان الله, before the day of judgment, okay, will be fitan, not one, many fitna, كقطع الليل المظلم, as a piece of the dark night. SubhanAllah, you know when you're in the middle of the night, very darkness, very dark. SubhanAllah, Rasulullah described that fitna is the same of this. Very dark. Darkness. SubhanAllah, fitna after fitna. Person wake up in the morning, mu'min. In the night, wayumsi kafir. He become a disbeliever. In the night, he become a believer. In the morning, he become disbeliever. He sell his deen for the material things from dunya. SubhanAllah. So this is really, really dangerous. We have to be careful from fitna. Tayyib, SubhanAllah. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أنذر حديث قال والذي نفسي بيده ليأتين على الناس زمان لا يدري القاتل في أي شيء قتل ولا يدري المقتول في أي شيء قتل. يا لطيف. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he said a time will comes and he swear by Allah والذي نفسي بيده سبحان الله ليأتين there's a time will come upon people لا يدري القاتل في أي شيء قتل أو قتل. The killer, he doesn't know why he killed. And the person he killed, he doesn't know why I've been killed. What is the reason? SubhanAllah. Wal'adhu billah. Nas'al Allah, may Allah save us from that fitna. Another hadith, hadith sahih. Qala Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qulu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Walladhi nafsi biyadihi لا تذهب الدنيا حتى يمر الرجل على القبر فيتمرغ عليه ويقول يا ليتني كنت مكان صاحب هذا القبر، وليس به الدين إلا البلاء، وليس به الدين إلا البلاء، أي من شدة البلاء والفتنة. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he said in the hadith by the he swear by Allah سبحانه وتعالى لا تذهب الدنيا، the dunya will not go on until a person he will pass by the grave. فيتمرغ عليه يعني he will flip his body on the sand next to the grave out of sadness, out of stress, and he will talk to the owner of the grave. He said, I wish that I am the owner of this grave. Because the bala, the test, the trial, the musibah, the hardship is so high and so pain that a person, he wished to be that person who is died. Subhanallah. May Allah save us from fitna. Always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma, say with me, Allahumma, inna na'udhu bika min mudillati al-fitan ma zahara minha wa ma batan. The mislead fitna, the misguide fitna. This is how we should ask Allah all the time. Wallahi, if we rely on our iman, we will fail all the time. We only rely on Allah to save us and protect us during the fitna, because sometimes fitna is so high we cannot even handle. Some of the people, they will lose, they will leave their religion when they see the fitna tul mal, the money fitna, the money trial, fitna to sultan, the what do you call, the chair fitna, the position. Subhanallah, when he get very high position, it's a big fitna to remain and subhanallah his deen. Fitna to sultan. That's why ulama, sahaba, they used to run away from fitna. Fitna to nisa. Wa fitna, so much kind of fitna nowadays. Fitna to qatl, killing fitna. Subhanallah. What Imam Ibn Hajar said, now we come to conclusion. What we should do in the time of fitna. Ibn Hajar, he said, ففي الحديث تحذير من الفتنة والحث على اجتناب الدخول فيها وأن شرها يكون بحسب التعلق بها. In this hadith, the hadith, يعني concluding, it's warning us from the fitna and encourage us to run away from fitna. Don't involve in it. Don't mix with it. And the fitna more evil, subhanallah, will be what do you call, the person will be influenced with the fitna more and more if his heart attached to it more and more. As much he attached to the fitna, as much he will be misguided. So when you see fitna, run away from it. For example, a person is working in this environment, in this job, if there is haram, doubtful, fitna every day, don't say, ah, I am okay, later on I will be strong. If you find yourself start affected, leave it, find another job. Don't put yourself in the middle of the problem, then you said, ah, I cannot handle. Subhanallah. So that is a Muslim should be run away from fitna in order to save his iman and faith. Another person, he has a son. He put his son with the Christian school in order to get better education or better English. If you see the effect over your son, in his iman and his faith and his akhlaq, take him out. Or in the beginning, don't put him in. After you put him in and this and that, and after that, you cry to the Sheikh, ya Sheikh, my son want to leave Islam. Type of Sheikh, he doesn't have a remote control to change. You put your son in the problem. And then you complain, Shaykh, save me. Subhanallah, that's most of us. We put ourselves inside the fitna, then we come crying after the problem comes. Subhanallah, my daughter, I allow her to work where is haram and where is influence with a man and boyfriend and girlfriend and this and that. Afterward, she want to marry maybe non-Muslim. No, my daughter, you cannot. But why you put her in this environment then? Why you allow her to travel by herself and to have a bad friends? So this is most of us mistakenly we involve in fitna, later we complain. SubhanAllah, we should avoid it. We not open the door for the fitna. SubhanAllah. طيب. And what the Muslim should believe towards Sahaba? And what is the era happened between them, let's say Ali radiallahu anhu and Muawiyah? We should hold our tongue to speak about them in bad way. That's a true believer should do. Because the Sahaba, whatever happened to them, some of them mujtahid. He tried to do ijtihad. If his ijtihad is correct, he will get two rewards. And if the other Sahabi, he has ijtihad, but he wrong, he still be rewarded by Allah. Because Sahaba, they want the best Khalifa who can be, subhanAllah, establish the justice for the Ummah. So they not have a clash because of their desire, or because of money, or because of issues. So subhanAllah, that we should hold our tongue to speak about them in bad way. And subhanAllah, when Ali radiallahu anhu been asked about who been killed in the time of Saffin, in the battle of Saffin, Ali radiallahu anhu said, inshaAllah, qatlana, whomever been killed among our group, and whomever been killed from their group, they will be inshaAllah in Jannah. Look at Ali radiallahu anhu, because he know they have a clashed, subhanAllah, and they fought each other. They did not fight for sake of wal'adhu billah, they call each other the kafir, or they because hate each other. No, because they want to establish the country in the peace and justice. So that's why, like, how can I say, let's say we have government and we have police, and one group, they want to take over from the Khalifa, and we ask the police to stop them. Those who try to take over, they are Muslim. And who are going to stop them? Also Muslim. So we cannot call, they fight each other in this particular part, they are wal'adhu billah out of Islam or something like that. Okay? And Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, I wish and I hope that me and Talha, one of the Sahaba, and Zubair, one of the Sahaba, from those, Allah says, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورٍ مِّنْ غِلٍّ إِخْوَانًا إِخْوَانًا عَلَى سُرُورٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ. We take and we removed whatever inside their heart from hatred. إخوانا, they are brotherhood. عَلَى سُرُورٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ, they will be inshallah in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised praise who is really subhanallah believe in Allah, and he does not have the hatred towards his brother in Islam. SubhanAllah. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, all this ahadith or evidence or saying we should memorize in order later on, if one of the Shia or other groups, they says, we hate this Sahabi because they fought Ali radiallahu anhu, or they have, we said, no brother, stop. We hold our tongue to speak about the greatness, the great generation. Look Umar ibn Aziz, what he said. He said, when he been asked about what happened in the Sahaba, in the issues, small issues, he said, تِلْكَ دِمَاءٌ طَحَّرَ اللَّهُ يَدِي مِنْهَا. This bloodship or bloodshed, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify my hand from this to be involved in. I will not involve my tongue in. I wasn't there, I didn't involve in this issue, on this misunderstand each other, or they fight each other a little bit, so I will also not involve my tongue in it. SubhanAllah. And he said, مَثَلُ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَثَلُ الْعُيُونَ ودواء العيون ترك مساسها. سبحان الله. Beautiful saying. He said, the example of the Sahaba of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like the eyes. And the medicine of the eyes, to not touch the eyes. For example, somebody, he has something in his eyes, don't put your hand in the eye, it will be more pain and more sick, more disease. So you have to, don't touch the eye. That is, subhanAllah, the medicine of the eye. So that's how he say, they are the Sahaba, they are like the eyes, they are the best, subhanAllah, of the best. قال الإمام أحمد, when he been asked, ما تقول ما فيما كان بين علي ومعاوية, what are you saying about what happened between علي رضي الله عنه and معاوية? He said, ما أقول فيهم إلا الحسنى, I will say only الحسنى, I only say the good towards them. Subhanallah. This is Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Our heart is very kind to the Sahaba. Not those evil, they claim we love Ahlul Bayt, and then from other side, they stab all the Sahaba with the knife and with their words, subhanAllah, in bad way. وَسَأَلَ رَجُلٌ الْإِمَامِ أَحْمَدٍ بِنْ حَنْبَلٍ عَمَّا جَرَى بَيْنَ عَلِي وَمُعَاوِيَةٍ فَقَالَ تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَلَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. He said, refer from verse from Quran, this ummah, قَدْ خَلَتْ, this nation is already passed by. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ, they earned what they did. وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ, and we earn what we are doing. And we will not be being asked about what they did. So Allah will not going to ask me, subhanAllah, what happened between Muawiyah and Ali radiallahu anh? So this is why I have to put my nose in wrong, talk about them in bad way or whatever. So Muslim should be hold his tongue, talk about Sahaba in bad way. And this is madhab Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said, وَيُمْسِكُونَ عَمَّا شَجَرَ بَيْنَ الصَّحَابَ وَيَقُولُونَ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْآثَارَ الْمَرْوِيَّةِ فِي مَسَاوِيهِمْ مِنْهَا مَا هُوَ كَذِبٌ وَمِنْهَا مَا قَدْ زِيدَ فِيهِ وَنَقَصْ وَغُيِّرَ عَلَى عَنْ وَجْهِ وَالصَّحِيحُ مِنْهُ هُمْ فِيهِمْ مُعْذُورُونَ إِمَّا مُجْتَهِدُونَ مُصِيبُونَ وَإِمَّا مُجْتَهِدُونَ مُخْطِئُونَ. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. Beautiful saying of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. He said, we should hold our tongue talking about what happened to the Sahaba in their error or misunderstand each other. Because this author, this narration, what we receive, some talking about their mistakes. Some of this narration is kazib, lied, is not true. And some of this narration, zida fi, yani they add in it. And they did not pass to us in the correct form. Subhanallah. And if that narration is authentic and correct, we say about Sahaba, ma'dhurun. They have a, what do you call, udhur. They have a, what do you call, they are not guilty. Why? Because they are mujtahidun. They did ijtihad. They try hard to find what we should do in this situation. And some of them, mujtahidun, musibun, who has ijtihad and they have a correct fatwa. And some of them, they did ijtihad and they have a wrong fatwa. And both of them, they will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is how the ulama should believe about the Sahaba radiyallahu anhu. I think there's so much ulama spoke, I just summarize some of them for you. And we are, as a Muslim, wish haram for us to curse the Sahaba. And what is the dalil? If one person we hear or we, subhanAllah, and personally me, wallahi, I hear by my ear a person, they call him, he's a scholar of Islam. he cares Sahaba openly, and he put his YouTube, he put his record in the YouTube. He cares Aisha radiallahu anha, he cares Abu Bakr and Uthman and Ali, Uthman and Umar ibn Khattab. He cares, وَلِعَذُ بِاللَّهِ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ. He said, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ, what an evil tongue talk about these great people, which Allah pleased from them. First of all, قال تعالى والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. رضي الله عنهم, Allah pleased from them, and ورضوا عن, and they are pleased from Allah. This is accreditation for the Sahaba. This is what you call virtue for them. So we're not allowed to curse them. Another ayah, والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا. And those who harm the believer from what they did not do, they carry بهتان عظيمة, they carry big lie, big sin, والعياذ بالله. So who claim about the Sahaba in wrong, subhanAllah, faith or wrong ideas, how much sin they earn. From the Sahaba, this is two ayat from the Quran, from Hadith. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, قل صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا تسبوا أصحابي, don't curse my companions. فوالذي نفسي بيده, by the soul, by my soul, the one in his hand, Allah, refer to Allah. لو أن أحدكم أنفق مثل أحد ذهبا, wallahi, if one of you, he spend donation, sadaqa, as much as the mountain of Uhud, ما أدرك مد أحدهم ولا نصيفة, he will not reach the level from them if they donate one piece of the subhanallah plate. And if a person, bring a gold the same weight of the mountain of Uhud and give donation in the path of Allah, he will not get the reward as one of the companions he donate piece of plate, subhanallah, even half of it, subhanallah. وَلَا تَسُبُّ أَصْحَابِي, don't curse my companions, subhanallah. And another hadith, مَنْ سَبَّ أَصْحَابِي, whomever curse my companions, فَعَلَيْهِ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ, Allah curse him and the angels and the people and all people. Allahu Akbar. Were there people who curse the Sahaba? The hadith, rawahu Mu'jam al-Tabarani, subhanallah, wa Mujma' al-Zawaid, wa fi silsilat al-ahadith al-sahiha, wa sunnah li Ibn Abi Asim. And the first two hadith, the one I translate in Bukhari and Muslim, subhanallah, la tasubba ashabi in Sahih Bukhari. Another hadith, وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, لعن الله من سب أصحابي, Allah curse whomever curse my companions. And وقال رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, سباب المسلم فسوق, whomever curse Muslim, whomever Muslim curse another Muslim, that is فسوق. فسوق والعياذ بالله الفسق, it's a bad character. وقتاله كفر, and fighting the Muslims is disbelief. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا ذكر أصحابي فأمسكوا, if the صحابة mention, hold your tongue. وإذا ذكرت النجوم فأمسكوا, and if the stars mention, so hold your tongue. وإذا ذكر القدر فأمسكوا, and if the destiny, القدر mention, hold your tongue. So here we've been ordered to hold our tongue in three. And this hadith, Mujma' al-Zawaid wa al-Tabarani, subhanAllah wa sa'a. So this is a hadith very good. Why? Because when somebody talk about Sahaba, we should hold our tongue. We shouldn't involve talking about the Sahaba in a bad way. And also, if somebody mention about the knowledge of the stars, who talk about fortune teller, talk about future, talk about because of this star, we see next year we will have a good time. If you see some marks in the sky, those people, they call them al-munajjimun. Is have a militia like this? In Arab country, they have some people. I saw this next year will be happen. something like to the earth. They, from the stars, they try to claim about the future. Okay, we shouldn't involve in this or hold our tongue or believe in this. وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الْقَدَرُ فَأَمْسِكُوا. If also the destiny mention al-qadr, we should hold our tongue. SubhanAllah. We shouldn't say, there's one group of, they call al-jabriya. We talk about khawarij also, we can talk about jabriya. They says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote everything upon me. So if I do zina, Allah wants me to do zina. If I steal money, Allah wants me to steal money. Because Allah wrote it about me. They start, they says, I've been forced to do the sin by Allah. That's what they claim. This also backs, they misleaded groups. I wish I continue, subhanAllah, but at the time going to be finished. Inshallah, next week, I try my best to cover up about all the doubts, the khawarij, the one passed by, and until the, subhanAllah, what happened between the khawarij and Ali radiallahu an, and how Ali radiallahu an been killed, wal-abla, innocent, mazloom, subhanAllah, mazloom, and who killed him, they are zalim, they are wrongdoers, radiallahu anhu, wa arda. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with Ali radiallahu an in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and give us the iman and give us al-wasatiyya, the middle, and not be extreme in any things, and make us analyze the Quran in right way and in depth way, not in wrong way. سبحان الله. May Allah save us. وجزاكم الله خير. وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. إن شاء الله. We have some time for question. We had a question in the beginning. Sister, can you repeat the question? بسم الله الله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين. The sister asking nice question. She said, is it bid'ah to give qurban, to give الذبيحة, the slaughter sheep for the Eid, for the Eid al-Adha, okay, for the festival of the Muslims? Is it okay for us to do in another country? Is it bid'ah, innovation to do that? A sister, for the udhiyah, for the slaughter sheep, we are allowed to slaughter in anywhere, in any place. And we up to us to do whatever we like to do with it. It's up to the Muslims. But what is the sunnah? Sunnah to divide that qurban or that slaughter sheep to three parts. Third for you, third you give hadiyah, and third to give donation sadaqah. If you are willing to give sadaqah in all the qurban, no problem, it's not an innovation. It's nothing to do with it. It's up to you how much you want to give sadaqah. It's up to you whatever and whomever you're willing to give. No any problem for the qurban. Wallahu, Allah knows the best. If you are willing to have one sheep here and one sheep in poor country, also good. You get two. You follow the sunnah and also you help the poor. SubhanAllah. If you are willing to send all because you believe those people, they are really necessary, they are really in need, also you can do. And I advise you to do both. So you will out of all this talking. Alhamdulillah, all of us, we buy meat, 1 kilo, 2 kilo, 3 kilo, nothing wrong. If one time we buy one sheep and sheep, and we divide third for our house, we save, it can enough for us meat for 2 months or 3 months. That's how we do in Arab country. We have, subhanAllah, the third of my, and also in the same time, I can give donation to slaughter overseas. SubhanAllah, nothing wrong with this, because some of the country, poor country, the udhiyah is cheap, doesn't cost so much. So yeah, you still can earn the reward, inshallah. Allah knows the best. Wallahu a'lam. Jazakumullah khair. Any other question?
Ah,
Inshallah, next week I will go talk about it in depth. But I just give you a general information that Ali radiallahu anh, when he has khilaf with Muawiyah radiallahu anh, all the people in Sham, Syria, Iraq, Palestine, all this country, they want Muawiyah to be Khalifa. And all the people in Medina and all, they want Ali radiallahu anh to be Khalifa. So we cannot be two Khalifa because we have one country. So Muawiyah radiallahu anh, he won the Khilafa because the people want him. And Ali radiallahu anh, he won the Khilafa because the people want him. And both of them think it's the right to be a Khalifa. I am responsible for the Ummah. So I have to do something. Then they have Khilaf and they went to fight each other. Then after that, subhanAllah, Ali radiallahu anh decide the Shura to choose two Sahabi, Amr ibn al-As and Abu Musa, to be as a judge in this situation. Okay, and Ali radiallahu anh, he went back. And they decide to give the decision until Ramadan. Yani delay a little bit. So Khawarij here, the 12,000, the one I mentioned, they said, A'udhu Billah. They want to refer to the hukum, to the law and principles and the judge to the human being, not to the Quran. A'udhu Billah, they are out of Islam. Philosophies, weakness in their thinking. Any child thinking, I can say. Child thinking. I mean, subhanAllah. What are you saying? Those two Sahaba, of course they will put the Quran as a judge. Radiallahu anhu. So this is the beginning of the Khilaf. Inshallah, more depth I will talk in details. Subhanallah. Today I just talk about who is a Khawarij and what they believe and what is their bad character and to warn us from fitna. Later, inshallah, next week, if Allah give me life, I will talk about the issue, how it's happened, and what is, who been killed, and this, inshallah, if Allah give me life. Jazakumullah khair, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are there other question? Inshallah, barakallahu fikum. Jazakumullah khair, subhanakallahu wa rabbana wa hamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.